flocked a 16-year-old kid from Windmill of the Bronx. As you can see, he about getting that money, and he definitely about putting that pain in too. And right now, we gonna take a look at Tay Flock's story and get to know him better as a person and as a character in the Tribe War Reloaded series. So shit, let's go. $30K to Tay Flock and shit. You know you wouldn't pass up that. Next thing you know, Tay Flock got the call on everybody. Shit, he even tried to call Tyreek, but you know he was on. Even though Tyreek wasn't there for him, Gotti always had his back. And Gotti had came all the way to the Bronx to get Tyreek situated and shit. So now, after he got his gun, he was ready to take his trip to Third Side. Breaths for a second, knowing that he take a man's life tonight, there's no going back from that shit. But anyways, he had to do what he had to do, get to that money as always. Next thing you know, Tay Flock had one or two, he let off the whole fucking clip, thinking he hear Rico. But little do you know, he hear Rico's little cousin, Baby Trey. And that wasn't the intended target, but Tay Flock ain't give a fuck, at all. That next day, Tay Flock had came to Manny World to go pick up his money from OG Fredo. But the thing is, Fredo couldn't give him that whole 30 that he promised. And he tried to make Tay Flock set up for 15. But he wasn't fucking with that at all. Fredo always tried to look out for Tay Flock after Tay Flock cousin got killed in Manny World. And shit, this right here was a prime example of that. Fredo even tried to reason with Tay Flock, but Flock wasn't trying to hit none of that. He was only there for one thing, and one thing only, and that was that bread. Really? Flock ain't give a fuck who he is. The body was dropped that night, and he was supposed to be receiving 30K from it. But usually, things don't always work like that when you're in the streets. After walking out the St. Mary's Projects, Tay Flock was pissed off. Like a motherfucker, too. Cause that was not what he wanted to hear at all. Cause he promised all his guys in the game that he was gonna get him straight off the earnings that he got off the murder. But shit, beggars can't be choosers at all. Fredo ended up giving MOB a block on 500 shit in Manhattan with JoJo and the rest of the 500 members. Even though it wasn't 30K, they still had a block where they could sell drugs and get money on. One night, one of the MOB gang members named Oscar was chilling on the steps in 120th. But little did you know, this night would be the night that someone would end up taking his life. Shit. RP MOB Oscar. Because Oscar was a good kid, but he was just hanging with the wrong crowd. After Oscar died, there was a whole bunch of conflict going on in MOB. People started to stop gaining trust with each other and stop giving the fuck altogether too. And Tay Flock confronted him, and Tyreek ended up slapping him in the face. That was a hard ass smack too, I ain't gonna lie. And now the result, Tay Flock ended up backing a gun out of him. As more and more episodes come out, Tay Flock begins to progress his character in the Tribe War Reloaded series and shit. We gonna see how he do in the next few episodes. Alright, look, man, I know. I've been going for a while, bro. And look, I could explain, my nigga. Like, I could explain, bro. 4 months, you feel me? But y'all definitely did y'all thing in 4 months, bro. Y'all got 4 of my videos at a thousand plus views and shit like that. So I'm fucking with that for sure. And at the time of this recording, I got 577 subscribers. So I want to thank y'all for that at the time of this recording, man. But I'm out, man. Ah. What the fuck did I just do, bro?